Good morning and welcome to the Tommy Watson Show, sponsored by Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers. I'm your host, Doug Dershimer. We're coming to you live this morning from the sports lab at Lambert High School with Coach Watson. Coach Watson, good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for being here. Thanks for allowing us to do this show and excited to be here.
Well, we can't wait to start looking at the game highlights. And when we come back, we'll take a look at the Lambert Longhorns victory on Friday night over the Lassiter Trojans in Cobb County. And we'll be back in just a moment. Welcome back to the Tommy Watson Show. And Coach, what a great night, Friday night.
It was. You know, we had some goals going into the game that we wanted to accomplish from the previous scrimmages and the previous, you know, the first game of the year. And it was, you know, one of our goals was to start fast. You know, we kind of started slow here and there in the last couple of games. And, man, we come out and, you know, we kicked off. Ryan did a great job kicking the ball in the end zone, pinning them deep. And, you know, we had an interception on the first defensive possession, and, you know, went right down and Ryan got a field goal. So, man, it was a lot of positives, a lot of positives to the night, a lot of good stuff to build on. So, very excited.
Awesome. Coach, it's been 1,758 days since we put 50 points on the board, and last night we did a great job.
Yeah, scoring 50 points is not easy. You know, you have to be executing in all three phases, and we did. I think we had five turnovers via special teams, via defense, and had a score on defense. So it takes a lot of effort to go in and score 50 points. Kids played great. Coaches did a great job all week and last night. So very excited about the future for sure.
Well, you said Ryan Dagansky picked off again in the end zone, again for a touchback, and they do get the ball in the first series, and let's see what happens here.
They come out to start with. They tried to spread us out and throw the ball on us a little bit, and we'll talk about some adjustments we made there. You see, Jake Johnson, the senior outside linebacker, made a phenomenal play dropping in the curl flat, got the first pick of the game, and here we go. We're off and running. We come out in offense. We open up with Kojo on a jet sweep. Great run, toughness. You know, the thing about that run right there is Kojo, the ball's designed to go outside, but Kojo, just being an athlete, cuts it up inside and gets back to the sideline. Just a great play for the Longhorns for sure. They play pretty good defense, slow us down, and hold us to a field goal. And here we got a 42-yard field goal that Ryan D splits it right through the middle. Great snap, great hold, great block, and good execution by the special teams for sure.
Coach, we were down that sideline in the end zone, and that could have been good maybe from 55. He really hit that.
Yeah, we talked about Ryan a lot, man. He's a weapon in high school football. Glad he's on my team for sure. So we go back out second series, and defense is playing hard, man, swarming to the football, doing what they coach to do. Very excited, man. Playing fast, playing physical. That's what I ask them to do. Here they get them three and out again. Great job by the punt return team. Davis Dawes fair catching the ball. Give us the ball in great field position. A nice little throw out by Levi to Ethan Terry. Two sophomores playing in the second series of the game on offense. Very exciting. The future is bright at Lambert for sure. Come out, punt, man. Here's another example of being a weapon by Ryan. I mean, it is hard for high school kids to field a ball that is high kicked as this young man does. What a weapon he is. And Ryan's a great player, great kid. He's got a bright future ahead of him. We got him for the rest of this year and another year. So the future's bright for him for sure.
Coach, two quick turnovers by the Longhorns, and that was kind of the name of the game last night. We got five on the night.
That's correct. That's correct. No. Anytime, you know, again, I tell you the same thing I told you last week. We got three beliefs. The team that plays the hardest, the team that hits the hardest, and the team that takes care of the football is going to win. Here's a little wrinkle we started doing. You know, our little quarterback, James, he's very good outside of the pocket. And we started putting in some sprint out this week, and here he is just making a play, getting it to Kojo Anshui and playing, man. Love what we're doing on offense, defense, special teams. Great job here by the offensive line. Harrison goes untouched for 20 yards. Great blocking, great execution, great. I mean, I believe I could have scored on that play. Just great. Go up
10-0. That's right. 4:49 left in the first quarter, and we're up 10-0.
Yes, sir. Start fast. That was the goal. Start fast.
After the first quarter, the Longhorns are up 10-7. Here are the second quarter highlights. Coach Watson?
Yeah, you know, we come out the second quarter. We have a penalty, if I'm not mistaken, get behind the chains, and we just call all verticals looking to, you know, maybe get the ball to Kojo Anshui out there, and James does a great job reading it out and finds number three running down the seam wide open. So great play out of Dan, great play out of James. Good job pass blocking. You see they walking people up, blitzing us. Great job out of the O-line. Great job out of James standing there and getting the ball off. So great play. Flip the field position on them. Here we come back at them. We're trying to just line up and play our style of football, you know, trying to run the football right at them. That was 3 or 4 yard runs early in the game. They turn into big runs late in the game, as you see. So great job. Again, sophomore in there running the football, Ethan Terry. Just moving it right down the field. Here we go, run a little bootleg pass. This is James's MO, man.
Here he goes.
You know, you said made the comment last week, he's like Johnny Manziel, and they turn one loose, he's back there running around. Great play, keeping your eyes downfield. That's Bradley Gabriel, who is one of our starting corners out playing some wide out this week for us. To my knowledge, that's his first touchdown as a Lambert Longhorn on the varsity. So,
what a play, Coach.
What a play. I mean,
James scramble back there is what makes him really special to watch back there. And great play.
Yeah, it's fun to watch. Sometimes on the sideline, you're like, James, what are you thinking? And then you're like, great play, son.
Yeah.
Glad he's on our team, man. He's a heck of a weapon. I think we kicked every extra point through the uprights. Last night we kicked Alex Mitchell, did the extra point duties for us, did a great job, put every one of them through the uprights. He's a junior. That's a very good kicker. That sometimes may get overlooked by Ryan, but Alex does a phenomenal job for us.
With 7 minutes to play, the Longhorns take a 17-8 lead.
17-8 lead. You know, the 8, we gave up a cheap one last night. I don't mind getting scored on, but I don't like giving them to them. But, you know, we made the corrections and got it going.
Coach Lassiter had some difficulties on special teams last night. This is one of their plays that I think this punt went 9 yards and really kind of, in a way, it turned the game a little bit for us.
Yeah, we thought last week as a coaching staff that we had an advantage in the special teams game. And so, you know, it come to fruition that we were correct and just put a little pressure on them and things worked out for us, man. Great job preparing our kids by the coaching staff. Our drive kind of fizzled out here, but again, we put Ryan out for a 32-yard field goal. Yep. We splitted uprights. Would have been good from a long ways. Yep. Just great overall football. Would have liked to got it in the end zone, but we feel really confident with Ryan kicking it from 45 in.
And with 2:29 to play in the half, we take a 20-8 lead.
Now, that's the start we've been talking about. Hadn't started as fast as we want, but again, Jake Johnson, just talked about special teams, man. They have a little blunder on snap. We're trying to come block it. We got them pinned back, and punter kind of fumbles the snap around, and ball ends up in Jake Johnson's hands, man.
Great play. Two for the big fella.
Two for the big fella. That is. That's awesome. So here we got Big Harrison Payton just running behind our big offensive line. Just we like to use the term bloody them up, man, just see if they want to really play football. And great job by everybody involved. There's James doing his little magic, man. Great effort out there, young man. Good job out the whole offense. Try a little trickery right here. You know, Levi does a great job playing in reverse. You know, we work on that at practice all the time. He's the backside cutback player. He's got to see the whole field as he's in ball pursuit. Great job out of him. Great job. Look at the black hat swarming to the football.
Swarm, absolutely.
Love it. Great job out of those guys.
Great start. Longhorns came out great in the second quarter, Coach, and at the halftime, we were up 27-8.
Yeah, you know, and I was very pleased with that. You know, again, I just said it earlier, we wanted to start fast, but we had a little adversity yesterday. We, you know, we got ready to load the buses and go to Lassiter. One of the buses wouldn't crank, and so it put us 25 minutes behind schedule. We get there, and we finally get dressed, get to go out for warm-ups, and there's a little weather delay. So, I mean, it was just like, man, what's next? And then we go out, you know, and the kids, they looked at adversity dead in the eyes, just like I asked them to do. And they, you know, they come out swinging. And great start, man. Proud of them. Proud of the coaches.
Well, when we come back, we'll take a look at the second half highlights of Coach Watson. You're watching the Tommy Watson Show. Welcome back to the Tommy Watson Show. We're going to take a look at the third quarter highlights. And Coach, last week you talked about the third quarter and how it hasn't been really good to us in our scrimmage games in our first game of the season. Last night, took a change.
Yeah, that's what, you know, we met offensively and defensively as coach staff and met with the kids. And that's, I challenged the kids as I addressed them before we come out of the locker room. Let's take this kickoff. Let's field the ball, number one, and let's take the opening drive and let's go score.
And we did, Coach. Yeah, I believe it was a five play drive, fantastic execution. Kids did a great job, so here we go with the second half highlights.
Yes, sir. We come out, we just run a little sprint out protection, and we seen something on film that they was doing. We call it a little trap technique out of the corner, and they was playing Kojo real hard on the bubble, so we just come out and ran a little smash concept and got Darren loose, got James out of the pocket. James very comfortable out of the pocket. Great throw, great catch.
Second long throw to Darren.
Yes, sir. Darren played well on offense last night for sure. And that's what I tell Kojo all the time, man. If people's going to try to take you away, you can't just try to do everything. Be a decoy sometimes, let other people do it. And he is unselfish as a player as I've ever had, and I'm proud of him for that. And here we are just getting him the ball out in space, and he's doing what he's doing, you know. The reason he's going to Ohio State is making plays like that. And here we got Big Hair. You know, we come line up in a little four wide, something different we've done this year. And Big Harris and big running back, he's just – he's bruising them. Offensive line's playing.
Coach was down on the goal line that play, and he flat out took that young man out.
Yeah, again, we have a rule for running backs. We ask you to get 3 yards with no blocking, and then we don't want you to run out of bounds. Try to punish them so it carries all throughout the game, you know.
A quick start with 10 minutes and 7 seconds left in the third quarter. We go up 33-8.
Great start, third quarter. Come out defenseless, chasing a great job out of those guys, and just almost, can't say enough.
Almost another turnover.
Very close for sure. But this, they swarming, man. They after the man with the football. They ain't no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Great job by that side of the ball, Coach Hurd and the coaches. And just overall great team play, man, on all three phases. And here we force them to just have a short, bad punt. And
which we really had a rattle on their punt game.
Yeah, it's hard. I mean, I've been on the other side of the ball on this now. It's hard punting out of your own end zone. It's, you know, that's tough, man. And so we just, you know, we had them rattled a little bit. And here we are again, come out, run a little play action off all of our gap plays, get the ball to Kojo. Great job out of the O-line, James, everybody involved. Good execution, man. Look like a machine. That's our goal, is to look like a machine on all three phases. Come out and just run quick game stops. James picks pre-snap read. Who's your best open? Who's your best choice? And all three of them is open. He goes with Kojo, and Kojo does what he does.
Coach, I think Kojo had about 8 or 9 touches last night, and yeah, it sure paid off.
We have a goal, and I'm not afraid to tell this, because, I mean, we have a goal going in every game that Kojo gets a guaranteed 10 touches. Mm-hmm. And that's not counting, quote-unquote, the concept-driven plays. We have a plan where Kojo is going to get 10 opportunities where he is for sure getting the ball. And then there's others sprinkled in. So, yeah, this, I mean, you got to, man. He's a great player. He's a great kid. He does everything we ask him. Oh, man, I love this play.
What a good play. Fourth down, right, Coach?
It's first down. First down, okay. We just converted the fourth down and won. And it's kind of a little trickeration that, you know, actually me and Coach Beach, this is a play.
Little wrinkle here.
Yeah, but we got this play. Me and Coach Beach was fortunate enough to coach in a USA All-Star game out in Dallas, Texas 2 years ago. Coach Beach was the head coach. I was the offensive line coach. But the offensive coordinator that was on the of our team, and he had all kind of tricks. So this is a play we stole from him. He's a guy that coaches in Pennsylvania. But, man, this is hard to deal with, you know. Great job. It takes a lot of execution. You look out wide out there. You got old big Grayson Maines and Tyler Vantry got their lineup at wide out. And great play, man. Great play. Let kids have a little fun. Back on defense, just getting out of it. Ball's on the ground. Old Harrison Payton.
There he goes.
He scores on offense, scores on defense. Hair's a weapon. Great job, everybody involved.
Coach Watson, on that pickup fumble by Harrison Payton, we had a little incident on the sideline there. One of our coaches, Coach Mateer, he got so excited. He was running the sideline, running faster than the official, and they had a little collision.
Yeah, Coach Mateer, he come right to me, Coach, my bad. But look, Coach Mateer is my man.
He's no doubt.
And that's what all the other coaches are looking around when I didn't start yelling and going crazy on him. I was like, look here. That is the one man that's got my back and got my kids back.
No
so
question.
I give him amnesty, but. He was fired up now.
He was,
I love that. I love
but
Coach
He is
going
to run on Monday, isn't he?
Somebody running.
Okay, somebody's running.
Back to the action, you know, here we go. We started making some subs, man. It was great to get everybody in the game. We got Levi here at quarterback, running the quarterback runs, and, you know, 7-8 yards up the middle, man. Good job out of him. Good job out the O-line executing.
And, Coach, you said a second ago, let's make sure everybody understands that everybody got in the game last night. Is that right?
Everybody got
everybody.
In the game.
Yes, everybody. Everybody addressed.
Everybody did. So that's always a big deal. Here we got a freshman running back who we think is going to be a superb player, Cam Bland. Man, we think his future is really, really bright at running back and defensive back. So very excited about Cam. Very glad to see him get in and run the ball. Here we just got a little RPO game going. Levi has the option to throw it out wide, or he can run the football. Either one depends on how the defense adjusts and the linebacker moves. So here he comes running. Levi had a lot of success doing that as a freshman, and we're trying to bring that to the table as on the varsity as well. Same type deal, running the quarterback RPO. Got Sharath Ragila, senior man, in there running hard.
He had a couple great runs last night.
Man,
I was so happy for him.
He did. We got down close to the goal line, man. I was trying my darnest to get him in the end zone because I know he's never scored in a varsity football game. But, man, he ran hard, and he's going to keep getting opportunities. Good kid, works hard, does everything we ask of him. I think this is a Levi, same type deal. Run a little RPO game, quarterback run driven. If the defense adjusts to the motion, quarterback runs it. If they don't adjust, he throws it. So it's a great job out of him. He's a sophomore running our – a lot of them guys out there on that field are sophomores and juniors, man. And that was very pleasing to me. The first time our quote-unquote second offense went out, they struggled to move the ball. But the second time our second offense went out there, they went right down the field and scored. So that was very pleasing to me. That'll kind of wrap us up on the, you know, watching the game plays. But, man, we said it a while ago. Anytime you can get every kid on the team in the game, that is huge for your program, because the only way they're going to figure out how to play is to get out there and play and get put in that fire in those situations. So that was very pleasing that we got everybody in the game.
Coach, it's all part the it's all part of your One Lambert theme that you have. You know, last night the band was there, the cheerleaders were there, we had a great crowd again. Just phenomenal atmosphere again on the road, and we're just building the culture.
That's the bottom line is culture, man. We have some beliefs that we believe in that our football team has bought into, our administration has bought into, our community. And, you know, it is One Lambert. You know, you talk about things that happened over the course of this past week. You know, I'm not sure everybody knows, but our ninth grade team beat West Forsyth. Our JV team on Thursday beat West Forsyth. So, man, I'm not sure that's ever happened in the history of Lambert football, where the ninth grade and the JV team beat West Forsyth on the same night in sub-varsity football. And obviously, West Forsyth is the measuring stick because they won the region last year. So just proud of those sub-varsity teams for winning, you know. And I told everybody a while back, our goal is to go 23-0, and we're off to a great start with 4-0 as a program. So very excited, man. Glad I'm here. Appreciate you doing this show every Saturday morning with me. And, man, wake up, go to sleep.
Coach, talked about the 5 turnovers last night were phenomenal. And we do have a little issue we need to talk about. Somebody's got the turnover chain.
Yeah, somebody's got the turnover chain. Coach Mateer showed up to the stadium last night, thought it was in his bag, and it disappeared. So if anybody knows where it's at, it's missing in action. We need to get that sucker back ASAP.
It do, but it didn't hurt last night not having it with those 5 turnovers, but we would love to have it last night.
Man, it would have been on full display last night for sure.
The Lambert Longhorns go to Cobb County and take on the Lassiter Trojans, and we take the victory 54-21. Next week, Coach, on the road at Meadow Creek for our second road trip of the year. And we played them last year, I believe. Is that correct? We beat them?
We did. It was, looking back at that game, it was a nip and tuck game there for a while. You know, it was a very close game. We kind of separated at the end. But Meadow Creek's going to be a team that, you know, they're going to – honestly, they'll probably look better than us. When you look at two teams lined up at the 50, you're probably going to pick more of their players over ours. So, I mean, you know, we gotta go out and have a great week of practice. And, again, road games are road games, man. I don't really like them. It messes up the whole routine, makes you get out of your routine. But, you know, I like our football team. You know, I seen last night, I was worried about being a road game and everything going on. But our football team is not going to flinch. I think our kids are going to go do what I ask them to do, which is to play as hard as they can, to hit as hard as they can, and to take care of the football. If we do those three things, I think we'll be fine. But it should be a good football game.
Folks, again, thanks for joining us. You can catch us on Twitter at the Tommy Watson Show or at the WAO Show. And you can catch us there every Sunday morning. We look forward to hearing you. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next week.
Hooker. How about it, bro?